I don't know if you guys recall that video of Ayana sitting in the toilet with her client, and she asked the client, "Why the hell are we sitting in the toilet?" And it just reflected the lack of sense going on right now. And that's exactly what the theme is of this video, just that whole video. Hey guys, it's Murad Murali. Hope you guys are all doing well today. Back at it again with another video. It is daily and consistent content 24/7. And we're going to get into this mess because Tasha K has spoken out in a live stream that she's taken to on her YouTube account. And what she's saying, none of it makes sense, guys. Don't buy any of this illogical nonsense because it's just that. Illogical nonsense. So I think she broke the stream. Well, not broke the stream, but she had nearly 25,000 people on there. Of course, people want to see her say something, and it would be stupid of you not to come on YouTube to break your silence in a video because you want to make as much coin as you can. And one, and you know, hopefully she did do that for herself and her own sake. That was probably the only good thing that she has done so far, because this entire video was absolutely nonsense. Do not buy any of this nonsense. And I'm saying that some people are, and it just, to me, you must be illiterate and stupid to even buy any of this nonsense. For the fact that she's out here talking about how she will never change a thing and doesn't take any accountability for her actions is like, that in itself was mind-blowing to me. It was mind-blowing. And she says they're talking about the First Amendment. Nothing about the First Amendment was related to what was going on in court. Nothing. Then you're talking about how you're going to take this to Supreme Court. What are you taking to the Supreme Court when this was a very clear win and this was a very clear defamation case and you clearly lied? You lied on somebody's name continuously and you refused to take those videos down, and in court you admitted to lying. You also were called out when it comes to perjury as well, even lying in court. You were brought to court because you were lying about somebody, then you were also lying in court. You admitted that those videos and the information that you were saying were not fact. You completely defamed somebody's character and was running around continuously saying that this person has STDs. This person is this, this person is that. And with warning, you did nothing and continued on with it. Continued the, what we call harassment and lies. And you're sitting here talking about we. You know, the words that she's using here are very clever here. We. Our, this content is our, this, as if it's a team and everything, when it's you, yourself, and yourself that sat there and put yourself in this absolute mess. I'm shocked by this video, because her at least, you know, taking accountability and apologizing to Cardi B would have probably reduced some of the financial damages to an extent. But she came with her chest and with her head to talk about how she wouldn't change a thing. You wouldn't change a thing, and now you're sitting in nearly 4 million debt. But you wouldn't change a thing. You wouldn't remove that 4 million debt. You're talking about how you're going to appeal. Your appeal is going to do nothing. Your appeal is going to do nothing when you yourself in court admitted that you defamed somebody. What is your appeal going to do? What is your appeal going to do? At best, the only angle that I feel like she can go through is that her lawyers were not sufficient enough in what they were doing. And you know, perhaps try something in that remark. But in terms of the defamation case, she admitted to defaming. There could be some malpractice with the lawyers. From what I'm seeing, Dennis Byron, you know, tweeted something. He's doing excellent coverage on this. But set aside from that, I think this video was shocking. It did a lot more damage than good. And I didn't expect it. And it really does show you the lack of accountability and the selfishness of this individual to sit there and not take any accountability for what's going on. Talking about the Supreme Court, girl, who is going to the Supreme Court for this, please? Are you Annalise Keating? What, like, what are you talking about? I don't know who wrote the statement for you, but it was absolutely bogus. And it just made no sense. You kept talking about the machine was doing this, the machine was doing this. No accountability, just continuous deflection, as if it wasn't you and your mouth that sit there and made those lies, but we're gonna blame the machine. That they tried to take you down many years ago and they tried to take you down now. It's very scary to see, because it's not as if she's, this is what she really genuinely believes this, that people were trying to take her down when it was herself. The mirror is right there, but instead you're looking left and right. You're not looking straight ahead. And it's scary because it shows the illogical and irrational thoughts of this person, yet people want to go and see this person's credibility. And I do feel like, you know, she does have, you know, gets the exclusive interviews. She does great content when it comes to that, but got way too carried away. And I think watching somebody like this is scary for yourself and your health if you feel like she is being rational with what she's saying. She genuinely believes she's being rational here. You admitted in court that you lied. You admitted in court that you were, it wasn't true, but you kept saying it. You admitted in court that you're not a journalist and stuff like that. You were incredible about it. You admitted this all. It came from your own mouth. And now you're talking about First Amendment. Talking about Supreme Court. Talking about how you're going to win some kind of appeal when it's not going to go anywhere for you. Talking about how you wouldn't change a thing when you're in 4 million debt. I didn't expect her to do a live video about it, nor did I expect it to be of this context. I thought it would have been much softer, showing some kind of attempt to learn and grow so that it could reduce any critique. But if anything, she's made it far worse for herself, and I'm genuinely gobsmacked by what she has said. It has made zero sense to me that you would sit there and do that. Zero sense, man. Zero, zero, zero sense. I was genuinely shocked that she would sit there and say that. People are obviously reacting to this, and this is what they are saying. Tasha is not learning her lesson. Tasha and her I Have a Dream speech. Right, man, is this The Color Purple? All my life I had to fight, man. What the hell is she talking about? She tried to justify her stuff. Tasha isn't even taking any accountability. The sheer amount of the audacity, the narcissism, and the extreme denial that exists with Tasha K appealing to the Supreme Court. Like, who do you think you are, man? The Supreme Court. Tasha just making things worse for herself. Tasha's ego is going to be her downfall. Tasha just said a whole lot of nothing in her recent live. I am in no way, shape, or form or fashion a fan of the woman she was in court against, but that wasn't right at all. I am genuinely shocked by this because I didn't expect it like this, man. Not Tasha trying to brand herself as a freedom fighter against the machine that promotes bad things in our community. I like talking about, oh, you know, there are machines out there that promotes views and money. That's all they want. But isn't that what you were doing when it comes to claiming that she has XYZ when she didn't? You were doing it for the views and for the money and the coin, which you also admitted in court. So what are you talking about? It's just, how can you not see your own actions and where it's put you in life? The fact that you can't see any of that, it's extremely dangerous to yourself and to the people that watch you, that you have no self-awareness. And you're doubling down on this, even though it's put you in 4 million debt and no appeal is going to work for you, and this ain't going to no damn Supreme Court. This was a defamation case that lasted one damn week. A defamation case is extremely hard to prove, but yours was easy to prove within a damn week. And you think that you want to appeal and take it to Supreme Court and they're going to care about what you're saying? I am genuinely like, this is insane to me. Again, I didn't mean to make this video long. I'm just trying to process this and it doesn't make any sense. This whole matter has progressed extremely fast in the last week, hence these, you know, current updates. But after this, I feel like I won't be doing any more because I don't think anything else is going to happen anyways. But this is insane to me. Insane. Guys, 4 million debt and you're talking about, I'm not going to be doing anything. The machine, ours, we, they're trying to take us down. Like, you, like, what are you trying to do? It's very manipulative, and a lot of her subscribers and, you know, are going to fall for the stuff if they haven't already. I'm seeing a few already falling for it so easily because they think it's a team, this, ours, we. Yeah, they're trying to take me down. Yeah, it's a herd mentality, and it brings people into it. It's very manipulative when really and truly she is the reason for her own demise. She admitted perjury. She admitted that she defamed and lied in court. This is what she said herself. So what are you talking about? Anyways, I'm just now going in circles. Let me know what your thoughts are, guys. Let me wrap this up. Mess and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys soon. And also, thanks for the last video. You guys were saying the shirt looks nice to me. I love this shirt. Let me just stand up for you guys. I love this. I love this brown chocolate kind of shirt on me. Like, it's just everything. And let me show you the trousers as well. Not that any of you guys have asked me, but like, it's just, I love this little combination. Yes. Anyways, yeah, bye.